an artist, I come from a very rebellious family. This is my first time I've actually created a piece that's gonna be printed and, you know, put onto a wall. Because usually my murals are tied down to an area. So with that in mind, I decided to pick a kaupapa that the story will always be significant no matter where it is, within specifically Wellington. There's two entities it represents. One is Rūaumoko, the god of earthquakes. That's the main kind of center point of the mural. And the second one is Te Kāhui Mounga. So that's a story of some of our most ancient ancestors. They were known to be the first beings that inhabited the land. We have an earthquake recorded nearly 600 years ago, which was the one that joined the island of Motukairangi Mirama to the mainland. And then you had the massive 1855 earthquake, and then you had our 2016 earthquake. In that context, you know, the modern and scientific context, that's exactly why I chose the Rūaumoko. And then on the other hand, our beliefs as Māori. So it's kind of tying the two into each other. I kind of go back to the basic fundamental of core whaiwhai. I create the flow first using just faint shapes and patterns. Then I fill those in with detail. If it's on digital, I'm in my studio because it's all happening in there. You have your rough sketch, then you scan that, put it on that platform, and then I draw on top of that. In terms of the Māori context, you know, anything you display, its wairua's essence will then kind of project onto the area. When you touch it, a piece of your Māori goes into that item. That's what gives the artwork its life force, what you put into it. That's how I see it. It determines and changes the energy of the space and draws people in because of that. Sometimes I think of the builders too, you know, because they're always in that environment. Add something that has meaning. Something that presents itself. That's why I do the things the way I do.